Another box of fun ready to go together in the workshop today is Revell's 64 Chevy Impala SS 2-in-1 kit. 157 parts in this bad boy being a 2-in-1. Let's get some slugs of styrene out on the table so we can take a look. First up is those yummy door panels. Those will look nice, all decorated up. We've got a trunk panel. Yes, that's right. The trunk does open on this bad boy. We've got some engine parts, radiator, air cleaner, seat backs, and that giant hood that you could also use to replace the roof on your house. We've got our separate trunk lid. Isn't that nicely done? Inside and out with the proper markings on it. We've got our beautiful Impala body. Full trim package on there. Very sharp looking. Of course, we'll be removing these separation parts when we paint. That just helps that you don't split the body or crack the fenders off while you're working on the kit. But that's a very sharp looking piece of hardware there. We've got our chassis here. Great detail underneath there. We've got those beautiful seats. Dashboard with multi-piece inserts on it. What else we got in the box? 157 parts in a 1/25 scale car. That is a lot of parts. We've got a full exhaust here. We've got numerous underhood parts. We've got our center console, drive shaft. What do we got on this one? We got that nice X frame. Sharp looking, well done. We've got numerous spring options. You can build this as a lowrider, as a standard height vehicle. We've got our nice rear seats there. You can see that it builds off that chassis for the interior. We've got our wheel backs, multiple engine parts here, body trim, steering wheel, engine halves, some more spring options for the front axle, intake, and we've got our suspension arms, our A-arms there. Looks like we've got some cables, some other equipment, some hoses and lines. Sweet. For the lowrider option, we've got a big bank of golf cart batteries in the back. We've got some cool horns. We've got more of our lowrider or stock height springs. All right, let's go to the other side of the table. What do we got here? We've got our decals. We've got our clear parts. We've got two trees of chrome. We've got two trees of tires. We got nice clear red lenses for those six taillights. We've got the nice Whitewall tire option. Beautiful tread, no name tires on there. Pad printed, and of course you could reverse them for black walls. We've got our lowrider tires. Black on both sides. Nice tread detail on there. On our chrome tree, we've got our knockoffs. We've got our chain steering wheel, we've got our hydraulic pumps, and we've got our wire wheels for the lowrider. And then the stock tree has our nice hubcaps on there, has our beautiful grille and rear bumper. We'll need to black those out. We've got windshield wipers, valve covers, all kinds of small accessories for the vehicle and engine on there. We've got our clear parts. We'll leave those in there till I start working on it. But you can see those look just fine. And then we've got our decals. We've got full dash instrumentation, numerous callouts for the vehicle, pinstriping, white walls, license plates, glass detail, even under the trunk detail, speakers, everything you could think of right on that decal sheet. Nice decal sheet. So I'm going to get everything washed off in some simple green, and we'll be back for a sub-assembly show-off. A couple of hours is all it takes to get to this point to where I can actually start throwing paint. We've got the frame assembled, and as you can see, I use the lowrider springs on it, the shorter springs. I have an idea for this. Being a 64 Chevy Impala SS, I have a specific idea how I wanted to do this. So everything looks real nice. It goes together quite easily. There isn't anything that will give you fits or make you freak out. The 327 goes together nicely. At least that's what the logos on the decal sheet say. It's a very nice engine. We will be painting that, and then I will be hand picking some details out. The chassis itself goes together nicely, no problems at all. You can see that that looks quite well. All I have to do is, once this is securely glued, I have to run that bar to the back of the differential there on that little mount right there. Then that will be final and ready for paint. But the front suspension, you see, you decide between one of those three spring heights. I use the shortest ones. As if it's parked, and all the way down on the ground, so that looks quite nice. And I'll be painting this all a nice gloss black. The interior is ready to go. There really is no assembly needed aside from the front seats. I'm going to do a white interior, had to assemble the front seats. I'm going to be doing a nice glossy white interior as if the interior is pretty much brand new on this one. We've got the main chassis here. I did attach the interior of the trunk. I did attach the firewall and the radiator support on there, along with the hood clip right there, so that I can get this painted all in one color, then mask, then do my interior floor color, then mask again and do my trunk. I could have left the trunk separate, but it's not going to bother me to quick throw a coat of paint on that while it's all attached. I wanted to make sure things lined up when I snapped the body on it, so I wanted it all together. That was more important to me than saving a few feet of masking tape. The body does snap on easily. The body, all it needs for assembly is this rear body piece here. You'll glue it in nicely and then let it sit while the glue is drying. Make sure your trunk lid fits. That's why the trunk's not attached to any sprue, because I really wanted to make sure that that fit perfectly, and it does. So that looks nicely. Now, there are hinges provided with the trunk. I'm not going to use them when I want to show inside the trunk when we do it. I will just be removing it by hand. Same as I like to do with the hood. The hood, you don't have to worry about any fit issues. We're not attaching a body panel, so we know that'll lay in there. And I left a part of the tree on there so I can get that painted. The body will be painted my chosen body color, which you'll see. Of course, the fan and belt assembly will be painted a basic black. We've got our radiator shroud, air cleaner, and battery going to be painted basic black. We've got our steering assembly and our shocks. Those will be painted up. We've got our steering components in the front that go on last, and our radiator hoses. Those will be painted a simple black so that they show up underneath. The batteries, the amplifier, and the horns will be painted. The batteries, of course, are going to be painted black. The amplifier will be hand-painted a light gray after it's primed, and the horns will be painted a silver and then highlighted with Molotow pen. The wheelbacks and the exhaust will be done up in silver. So, come along. We're going to be throwing a lot of paint today. This is going to take the rest of my day as far as modeling time goes to get all the different paints on this. You can come along and join me for most of it. Thank you. So what I've done here is I want to start fading the paint on the hood and everything. I sprayed it with some dull coat to give it a little grip. I took some Apple Barrel Award Blue, alright, and I mixed it 50-50 with some regular old Windex. Now I've got it mixed up, a real loose mix, real nice and jiggly-juggly, and poured some into my airbrush. And I've got my airbrush set to 10 PSI. And now I'm just going to mist on some lighter coats from a distance, like that. We'll let it sit, and what it will end up doing, you can see, is it will fade the paint for me. And as I mist on, I'll decide how much I want to put on and whatnot, and decide where I want to put it, and that will fade and bring down the color of the paint. You can see that that's a much lighter color. We got so much light in the shop here, so I can see what I'm painting. But you can see that that's a much lighter color blue than the paint, but it's still in the same family. So we're going to keep working on this and on the high points of the body and get some fading done. And when we're all done, we'll be back at the bench. Once the body got out of paint, I immediately started to assemble and paint on the interior, do trim work. You can see that on the dashboard here, I have attached the actual instrument panel. Now what I have to do is I have to lay a decal in there, and then I have to put a piece of clear glass in there as well, and then the dashboard is done. I've also worked on the center console, just doing some nice chrome trim on the inside. The nice thing about doing this as a customized lowrider that's a little beat up is I don't have to care exactly what a 64 Impala SS was like. I'm not building a concourse show car. I'm building a car that someone wanted to drop and make their own lowrider. I've done the silver trim. Now what I'm doing, so that it's not super shiny, I want it to be faded and crusty. As you can see, I have flat coated all the rest of the chrome on the vehicle to make it look like it's been sitting outside for quite a while. Is that when I stripe it with my silver pen, my silver Sharpie. Okay, normally if I leave it alone, it'll be pretty glossy. So after it has had about 3 or 4 seconds to dry, I've just been applying a piece of tape over it and peeling it off. And peeling it off will give me that nice dull finish that doesn't look so hot, but I mean, it looks like chrome trim, but it doesn't look amazing, and it doesn't stand out. It's not bright. It's not giving me a garish appearance compared. I've also done the same with all the trim on the body. I've done the exact same silver trim all the way around. Now I've got the sides masked off so that I can go in and carefully draw my body molding on there. Then take, once I peel this off, I'll just reapply it real quick and peel it off again, and I'll get that nice dull finish. So everything is fitting together just fine. You can see I've gone quite a ways on the old engine there. You can see that it looks pretty nice. I put the horns in, of course. We got the 327 in there. We got the master cylinder. We've got the battery, the radiator hose, the shroud, the radiator. We've got the clear bottle there. In the front, they say it should remain clear with a black lid on it, so that's how I left it. I've got those sweet horns under the hood. Everything looks real nice. I've got the amplifier, the battery packs, the golf cart batteries, the deep cycles, and the pumps in the trunk. She's got pumps in the trunk. I've got the underbody pretty much done. Just need to do a little bit more weathering on it, but not too crusty. I got to scrape it up a little bit because there's not a lowrider on the planet that hasn't hit the pavement. And then we've got those beautiful wheels and tires, and you can see those wheels and tires have been black washed on the inside. I just have to add the knockoffs before we're all done. But if I put them on now, messing with it, those knockoffs would become knocked off and disappear on me as well. So everything is coming out just fine. She looks great there. It's going to work out absolutely fine. And I've test fitted the body on there quite a few times to make sure that it looks right. So I'm going to button up the interior. And before I completely enclose the interior and the body, we'll come back for another look. With the interior assembled, and you'd be surprised how well these door panels and that dash fit. There's only a couple drops of super glue on there to hold them together. We've got the grill on the body. You can see how sweet that looks with the trim on the hood, with all that faded chrome. You can see the trim on the side of the body, and you'll get a better look at the final, of course. But that all looks great, and it looks just weathered up enough. Used but not used up. Faded but not rusted and crusted. So what I have to do now is snap the body on the interior, and that's a nice looking interior. I used the chain steering wheel, of course. We got the gauges on there. We got everything all set up with the black and white interior that I like. It really looks sharp. We're all set to go. All I've got to do is take the hood and the trunk lid back off. You can see that I've painted around the trunk lid. Once the vehicle is completely together, I will go ahead and trim out those taillights as well with some silver, once I know I don't have to touch them again. So I'm going to snap the body on. We're going to come back for the final. You'll get to see the whole thing all ready to go. I'm going to crust up the bottom just a hair more just for me, even though you hardly ever see it. And then we will be back and take that final look. Here we go! Revell 64 Impala SS is all done. As a lowrider in the process of restoration, he works hard. He's put his money into some sweet wire wheels with knockoffs. He's worked a little bit on the interior. It's pretty clean. He's got his amp and his batteries and his hydraulics in the back. Now all he's doing is saving up for a paint job on the outside. Once that's all done, he's going to work on that 327. But she's a runner. She looks good. The paint's just faded. She's been around the block a few hundred thousand times. I added just a little bit of toning underneath the gas cap and the door handles, where you'd expect to see a little bit of staining, a little bit of crust running down. Then I took some very light tile grout and puffed it on the sides to give us that dusty, faded, kind of flat look. So everything looks wonderful. Everything fits nice. I like my fading work on it. It looks pretty cool. I didn't go extreme. I didn't put a lot of rust on it. I just did some oil and grease and stuff to make it look bad, but definitely a daily driver that hasn't been painted in about 25 years. He is ready to head over to Earl Scheib's, pay for their $299.95 paint job as soon as he gets paid, and get some nice paint on there. You can tell it was dark cherry when it came out of the factory because of the paint under the hood, and the fenders, and the trunk lid. And then, of course, it was painted that nice metallic blue. And then over the years, it's just been fading more and more and more. He's representing with the Chevy Impala decal on there. There's a lot of cool stuff in this kit. If you want to build it a stocker, of course, you'll have these nice wheels, the nice hubcaps, and the nice white walls left over. If you do it as a lowrider like I did, use that chain steering wheel. Everything looks pretty awesome, and I really enjoyed it. There will be a slideshow at the end. Once again, thanks to everyone at ModelRoundup.com. Jack and Kirk over there, two great guys to work with. Real happy to have them on the channel so we can do some fun stuff like this, get some kits in, let you guys see how they build up. No fit issues. The body snaps right down. The trunk and the hood don't need any extra work to get them to snap right into place. You can put the hinges on them if you want, so you can frequently display it open or closed. I don't do that, but they will look good if you do so. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you at the next review.